Hello, Jason. Let's get ready to start your exam. Would you like to do the scales and technical work first, or would you like to do your pieces? Scales and technical work. Okay, in that case, can we please have E major scale, forte legato? And now A flat major staccato piano. Could you now play me E harmonic minor with a crescendo and diminuendo legato? Thank you, and let's have G sharp melodic minor, forte and staccato, please. Let's have the chromatic scale in similar motion, a minor third apart, starting on C and E flat, mezzo forte legato. Now then, with your right hand, E major scale in thirds, forte and legato. Thank you. Now we're going to move on to the arpeggios. Could you play A flat major with a crescendo and diminuendo staccato? Thank you. And now E minor arpeggio, forte and legato. And the diminished seventh on A flat, mezzo forte staccato. And the dominant seventh starting on E, piano and legato. Thank you, Jason. Now we're going to go on to do the exercises in the back of your book, and I'd like you to choose the first one. Which one would you like to do? Number 2A. Okay, when you're ready, start. Thank you very much, Jason. Okay, I'd like to hear 1A, a Russian song, please. Thank you very much, Jason, and we're going to move on to the pieces now. Your first piece is the Bach Courante, is that correct? Okay, when you're ready to start, off you go. Jason. Now let's move on to your next piece, the Sonata in F.
Thank you.
Jason. Now let's go on to your final piece, which is Water Wagtail by Scott. Thank you very much, Jason. Now we're going to do the sight reading next, and I'm going to bring that up to you on the piano. So if you can have a look at this piece, you've got 30 seconds to have a look at it, and if you'd like to have a practice, please feel free. And I'll tell you when it's time to play it to me. Play it to me now. Off you go. I shall play twice a piece in a minor key. Afterwards, I would like you to comment on the significant features of the piece, such as style, phrasing, and dynamics. And you can answer after either or both playings.
Dynamics, it starts off fairly quiet and then builds up in the middle of the piece, and the second half slightly louder than the start.
Anything else, or would you like to hear it again now?
Hear it again,
okay,
please. Time signature's 4/4, I think. That's mainly legato. The melody was in the right hand. The accompaniment was mainly block chords in the left hand. And I think it was like a dance.
Okay, so the second question. Here is a section of the piece. Tell me what cadence comes at the end.
Imperfect,
thank you. And the third question, here's a copy of the first part of the piece as I've been playing it so far.
Okay.
I'm going to play twice a version that includes three changes, which may lead to the pitch of the melody line only, or the rhythm. I'd like you to tell me where the changes happened and what they were. And you can answer after either or both times.
For on the first beat in the right hand, I think you played a C instead of a B natural.
Okay, thank you. I'll play it again then, see if you can get the other two changes.
In bar 2, beat 4, you repeated the C crotchet in the right hand, and in bar 1, of the left hand, you didn't play the second pair of quavers on the second beat.
Okay, thank you. Let me take that back. Thank you. I'm now going to play part of the piece again with a different ending, which modulates to a new key. Tell me into which key the music has modulated. The opening key is G minor, and this is a G minor chord.
Modulated to C minor, subdominant.
Thank you very much. So that's the end of the exam, Jason. Thank you very much.
Okay.